Miss Benson, your mother's here.
Thank you. Wow. Are you calling yourself my mother now?
Well, it doesn't get me a table in a restaurant, but it does get me in here. You're looking awfully cheerful today.
Maybe I'm just happy to see you.
Oh, well, careful. That could go to my head.
This is a cute picture of Jason and Michael, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. Where were they?
Jason had some business outside the country. He took Michael with him.
You don't even know where they went?
How could I ask him? Anyway, he wouldn't have taken Michael if it wasn't safe. And if he'd left him at home, the quartermains would have considered him ripe for the picking. Not to mention Robin would be all over him like a cheap suit.
Carla, I know you may think that Robin is launching a frontal attack against you while you're in here, but that's really not the case. And I think Jason really didn't know why the four of you couldn't live as one big happy family.
What do you mean, didn't know until when? Please tell me that you did not go back there and tell him that I was bad-mouthing Robin.
Oh, no, no, of course not. I just made it clear to him that for everyone's sake, he's going to have some decisions to make. Carly, I mean, if he's picturing a future with you and him and Robin all sitting around the table with Michael on his lap.
How could you do that to me?
Do what?
Why can't you just keep your mouth shut? I mean, haven't you done enough to ruin my life?
Could you back off a little, please? I mean, I am a visitor here, and you don't have many of those.
Do you know that Jason is the best thing that's ever happened to me?
Am I arguing? But may I also remind you, you used to say the same thing about Tony.
Don't change the subject, Bobby. You know what? If I lose him because of you, I will never forgive you. Never.
Don't you think you're overreacting just a little bit? I mean, you were concerned. All I did was suggest to Jason that he'd better be prepared to choose.
That's just it. You forced Jason to choose, and he will choose Robin. If you just keep your mouth shut and stay out of it, maybe let nature take its course, by the time I get out of here, things might be different. You know, maybe by then he'll care about Michael too much to leave him, even for her.
I get it. So what I should have done was suggest to Jason that the horse race is really between Robin and Michael, not Robin and you.
What you should have done was butt out then, and you should butt out now.
You're gonna use Michael to try and jerk Jason around, aren't you?
What Jason feels for my son is real. I'm not inventing that.
Oh, I see. So what you're hoping is that Jason is gonna ditch Robin for something that's a whole lot less real with you?
And you call yourself my mother? Whose side are you on anyway?
I'm on my grandson's. And maybe even on yours, believe it or not.
Okay, so then why shouldn't we be a family? Why shouldn't I be with the man who is the father of my child?
Well, you know, Carly, that would be just great. I would be very happy for the three of you. But a family is created by love, not coercion. Didn't destroying mine teach you anything?
Loss of that baby-snatching egomaniac that you married? Besides, Bobby, he pursued me.
Please, tell it to somebody who wasn't there. And you're prepared to repeat the same scenario with Robin and Jason, aren't you?
What? God, you sound as deranged as Tony. It's not even remotely the same thing.
Why do you go out of your way to sabotage people who've been good to you? Jason for one, me for another.
Okay, wait, refresh my memory. When were you ever good to me?
Oh, if you would have told me who you were when you first came to Port Charles, I would have welcomed you with open arms.
And how was I supposed to know that?
How could you not know? You made yourself my best friend. I told you all about the little girl I gave up and how much I missed her. That didn't mean anything to you, did it? Because you can't count on anyone else's feelings. Because you know how unreliable yours are. It's always about positioning yourself for the next thing, isn't it? And you used a little boy then, too, Lucas. You wormed your way into his affections, trying to get Tony to see the two of you as the perfect package deal, the same way you're using your own son now with Jason.
Why don't I ever learn? It doesn't matter what I do or how long I live, you're never going to be in my corner, are you?
Oh, my darling daughter. You may have been able to play Virginia Benson's heartstrings like a violin, but that is not going to work with me. This is not about corners. This is about you and who you want to be when you grow up, if you ever do. Can you be a real mother to Michael? Can you give him a real home with real love? Or do you want to see him raised by an unhappy man who feels like he's stuck with a self-centered, manipulative little brat?
Okay, so I think I'm starting to understand why you and Tony stayed together so long, because neither one of you is ever wrong.
Tony and I have both made our share of mistakes, but at least I don't go around repeating the same ones over and over again.
Not that I think for a minute you care, but if you ever wonder what my life is like for me, there you have it. You never seem like a friend to me, just another locked door. Look, Bobby, if you say anything else to Jason about this, you will never see Michael again.
Watch it. Somebody might just decide the person he'd be better off without is you.